guys. A lot of y'all have still reached out to me several times and just checking on me and telling me that I'm in your guys' prayers, and I can't tell you how much that means to me. It's been tough on me, you know, since I lost my son. Actually, I'm out here visiting now, so I'm married. But it's been 3 years and 4 months. And honestly, I hurt just as bad today as I did the day that he left me. I don't understand the reason why things happen, and I guess it's not my place to question anyway, you know? But I do believe in my heart that Nick, my son, was a part of something so much greater, something so much bigger than what I can see. You know, there's just some things I think in this life that we can't understand. We're not meant to understand. And a lot of people say, how can you believe in a God that took your child? Well, here's my answer. God didn't take my child. Sin, the devil, the world, that took my son. This world is so sinful, so hateful, so full of deceit and hurt. People look for any reason to blame God, but the fact is, it's not God. God allows these things to happen because we have free choice. I mean, we have the choice to follow in sin, or we have the choice to follow Him. That's our choice. But so many people follow the sinful route, and they go that way, and they stay lost in sin. I can tell you this. I wouldn't be here today if it weren't for my faith. I yelled at God. At first, I was so mad, so hurt. I can just remember waking up the next morning after I had such a horrible, restless night and couldn't sleep, and I just tossed and turned, and I finally just got so tired that I passed out. And I woke up that next morning, and my husband said something. He had to do something really quick, and he walked out that front door, and I screamed, God, why did you do this to me? Why did you take my son? How did you do that to me? I mean, I was so hurt. I was so upset. I blamed God. And I thought, what did I do so wrong to deserve God to take my only child? And then my mom and them started going to church. And this preacher, he came to my mom and dad's house, and he was like, you know, I'm so sorry about your loss. And he was like, why don't you guys come to our church, you know? And my mom and dad, they decided they were going to go, and I didn't want to go. I said, I don't want to go. I don't want to go to church. I don't want, you know, I wasn't ready. I was mad. I was mad at God. But, finally I was like, okay. My mom just kept at me, you know, and I finally said, okay. And I went to church. And I realized that everything that I was going through, I was blaming God because I didn't know what else to do. I guess it's because we think if we have this God that's so big, that's watching over everything and takes care of everything and knows everything, how could He not stop that? You know, so we'd look to blame Him, but then it's like, look at the world we live in. Look at all the pain, the suffering, the hurt, and it's because of sin. I mean, people don't walk into places and shoot people because they're living right with God. They do it because they're living in sin. They're not living right. The people that do drugs, the people that are out here stealing and all these things, you know what I'm saying? They don't do it because they're walking right with God. They're not going to church. These are people on the streets people who don't know God, people who aren't living right, and that's their free choice. They have to make that choice, and their choice was that they chose to follow sin, the devil. They chose to do those things. If you're walking with God and you're living right, you're not going to do those things because you know you can't do those things. There's so much sickness and stuff in this world because of sin. If we all lived right and we all followed God, I don't think there would be any of those things. No death, no sickness, no nothing. But we're never going to have that here on this earth, ever. We got to wait until the day that we get to heaven. And I know my son was saved. I know that he loved God with all his heart. He loved going to church with his papa on Sundays. And my dad had quit going to church for a little while. And I know Nick missed it. But he was a true through-and-through Baptist kid. Like, I had went to another church. It was like a non-denominational church for a long while. And he wouldn't go. He told me, no, it's not a Baptist church. I'm not going. So now, here I am at this Baptist church. And actually, it's right across from a cemetery. That's where I go to church. A great little church. There's not very many people, but the people that are there are, like, amazing people. They're, like, my family. I look forward to seeing each and every one of them every week when I go. After a while, I learned that I can't blame God for the things that have happened. I can't blame anything besides what it is. I know my son's safe and at peace, and I know that I'll see him again. That little boy means everything to me, and I'll live the rest of my life with this huge, huge part of me missing, and a big part of me hurting, and I'm always going to break down and cry. I'm always going to feel that pain, because, he's a part of me, and I love that little boy more than anything in the whole world. He's just most amazing little boy in the whole universe. But I finally got to come out here earlier in the day, and my husband, he's doing ride sharing with somebody to get to work. So I came out to visit my son.
Hold on. That's my baby boy over there. He's got his flags and everything, and he's all decorated for fall. And then, I don't know if y'all can see, but the church is down there. So, that's my church, and that's where I go to church. And,
shows that, people still care and that people are praying for me, and that makes me feel good. And it's those prayers that keep us going. I don't think we ever realize that we need those prayers, and we need to be able to stick together, and we need to pray for each other, and we need to do the best that we can every day for every person that we meet, because we don't know their struggles or what they're going through. But like I said, it has been the longest 3 years, 4 months of my life without my son. Holidays are still really hard for me. Mother's Day is really hard for me. Especially since he passed so close to Mother's Day. So that gets really hard. His birthday is rough. There's just so many things that it's really rough. And then things that he should have done, like graduation, that was really tough for me. I did have him a graduation party still, but it was just, I guess, bittersweet, I would have been so proud that he had graduated, but then it's like he's not here. And that, too, was a sadness that's in my heart. about how he never made it to his 16th birthday. You know, he was so close to being to his 16th birthday. He passed away May 11th. His birthday was July 14th. But he just never made it there, you know? And he would have got the car that I have, which is the Pontiac G6. He never got to go to prom. He's never going to have children. You know, it's all these things, I feel like. And so those things are always going to hit me hard, I think, and especially around the times that I feel like they would have happened. So that's always going to be hard for me. But I'm going to do everything that I can to always honor my son, do things to celebrate him, his life, to keep his memory alive. I think that's the best that any of us can do. We need to always be there for our loved ones. We need to take every day as if it could be our last. We need to hold those we love closer. If you're not speaking to somebody that you love and that you're, you know, that's like important to you and you're just not talking for some reason, pick up that phone and talk to them. Tell them you love them, because things could change in the blink of an eye. I mean, I would have never in a million years thought that my son would go to a hospital and they would treat him for bronchitis and release him. And to overlook around his heart. You know, just never in a million years did I think that, but you know, they did. The hospital failed him. But it is the way that it is, and we don't know. Each person that we love could be gone tomorrow. And then you're left with the regrets and the things that you should have said and the things that you wish you could have done. So, pick up that phone. Tell those people you love them. You never know. But anyway, I just wanted to get on here really quick. Thank you all. Seriously, thank you for every message. Thank you for every comment. Thank you for being so supportive, for being there when I just want to vent or talk or whatever. You guys are always right there to listen. Just truly from the bottom of my heart, I thank each and every one of you. And if there's anything I can do for any of you, whether you have a question, whether you want me to pray for you, whether, you know, anything, I'm right here. Anytime you need me, you message me, you comment me, I'm going to answer you back. I always do. I try my best to respond quickly, so thank you guys. Have a blessed day, and I hope to come back on here sometime soon, and I'll talk to y'all again, you know.